The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise, recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate Monday, April 1st, 2024, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, March 30th, 2024, was read and approved on motion to Senate adjourn.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentations of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Madam President, good afternoon. Let's begin by taking up the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 106, Senate Print 6525 by Senator Scarcella Spanton, an act to amend the private housing finance law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Scarcella Spanton to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President, and thank you to my colleagues here in the Senate for all your support in helping pass this legislation that will provide much-needed support and assistance to our veterans. Having stable and affordable housing plays such an important role in their transition, providing the foundation for our veterans to build their lives and reintegrate into civilian life. The Affordable Home Ownership Development Program is specifically tailored to help families achieve their dream of owning a home by offering financial aid and support. Its impact has been statewide. It has empowered countless New Yorkers to create brighter futures for themselves and their families through home ownership. Extending eligibility for this program to service-disabled veterans is a significant step forward in providing them with the stability, independence, and sense of community they deserve. This bill is a tangible way to honor their sacrifices and make sure that they receive the support they rightfully deserve. I proudly vote aye.
Senator Scarcella Spanton to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 107, Senate Print 6573 by Senator May, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator May to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President. I rise in support of this bill because we have a housing crisis, as everyone knows, in this state, and one of the issues has to do with how expensive it is to build apartment buildings. This bill allows New York to start building apartments the way they are built almost everywhere in the world, except in New York, in the United States, instead of building them along corridors like hotels. You build them, you structure them around entryways, and that allows a whole lot of new kinds of configurations of apartments, and it allows far less of the floor space to be dedicated to non-living space like corridors. So this is a bill about affordable housing, about making the process of producing apartments more affordable so that the apartments themselves can also be more affordable. I'm proud of this bill. I'm grateful that it's on the floor today, and I vote aye. Thank you.
Senator May to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 150, Senate Print 7130 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 357, Senate Print 6980A by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the Education Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Mayer to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President. I'm so pleased that this bill came to the floor again this year. I want to thank the leader and my colleagues. It passed last year in this House, and it needs to pass in the Assembly. But from a parent's point of view, there is nothing more important than ensuring the safety of our children in schools. And this bill would require that schools develop a plan for informing parents about safe storage bills when they have guns at home. Too many times a gun is at home, parents pay little attention to safe storage, even if there is a law that governs it, as we've passed. This would remind parents of the urgency of safe storage for guns and thereby reduce the likelihood or potential likelihood of a terrible accident involving guns at home. I'm pleased that my colleagues are with me on this. This is something that we must do to ensure the safety to the greatest extent possible for every child in the state. I vote aye.
Senator Mayer, to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 357, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Oberacker, Ort, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 51, nays 8.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 531, Senate Print 6551 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannis Kruger, Ort, Sewell Cousins, Wyke.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 588, Senate Print 6648 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the banking law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannis Kruger, Ort, Sewell Cousins, Wyke.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 588, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Kenzie Fitzpatrick, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Weber, and White. Ayes 41, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 620, Senate Print 7539 by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the civil practice law and rules.
Laid aside.
Calendar number 682, Senate Print 7375 by Senator Salazar, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannis Kruger, Ort, Sewell Cousins, Wyke.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 696, Senate Print 6409A by Senator Liu, an act to amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannis Kruger, Ort, Sewell Cousins, Wyke.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 718, Senate Print 7518 by Senator Breslin, an act to amend the judiciary law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannis Kruger, Ort, Sewell Cousins, Wyke.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed. Senator Gennaris, that completes the reading of the calendar.
Thank you, Madam President. Let's move right to the controversial calendar, please.
The Secretary will ring the bell. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 620, Senate Print 7539 by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the civil practice law and rules.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Madam President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk. I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that you recognize Senator Palumbo.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Upon review of the amendment in accordance with Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule it non-germane and out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Madam President, I appeal the ruling of the chair and ask that you recognize Senator Palumbo to be heard on that appeal.
The appeal has been made and recognized, and Senator Palumbo may be heard. Senator Palumbo.
Thank you, Madam President, and good afternoon. The bill in chief has to do with wage theft, so I'd respectfully argue that this bill, which has to do with retail theft, is certainly germane. The laws of this state are a fluid thing, Madam President, and when we see certain things like the scourge of retail theft that's been taking place in our state, recognized nationwide at this point, we need to react. And we need to have laws that have teeth. We need to have laws that deter crime. And I believe at the public protection hearing, I don't remember the exact number, but it was an exorbitant number of retail theft crime is a result of repeat offenders. So let me tell you a little bit about what this bill would do. So this bill simply creates a crime of coordinated petty larceny as a Class E felony. A person is guilty of coordinated petty larceny when he or she steals property at the same location as one or more other persons who are also stealing property, causing property damages, or facilitating the stealing of property, or causing property damage. And now this is a theory that currently exists in New York state law for a very obvious and valid reason, that when you have more than one person involved in the commission of a crime, that creates an additional threat of intimidation. And we have in the robbery statute, robbery in the third degree is forcibly stealing property. When you don't cause an injury, so you rip someone's pocketbook off of their shoulder, that's a nonviolent class D felony. That's robbery in the third degree. However, if another person is present, that's robbery aided by another, the exact same conduct elevates robbery in the third degree to robbery in the second degree, which is a class C violent felony, because of the additional threat of force by a second person being present. So, Madam President, this is not only germane to this bill, this is an extremely important issue that needs to be addressed. Sadly, the Senate One House removed a proposal by the governor to include an additional crime and aggravated penalties for assaulting retail workers. So this is certainly ripe at this point. And more importantly, we've had continued reminders of how dangerous the current climate has become. Just this past weekend, investigator Mike Thiech was involved apprehending some retail theft potential defendants, suspects. Someone was leaving with a TV. His accomplice was driving a vehicle that ultimately caused severe, debilitating, life-threatening, and may actually take his life. That investigator, as we speak, is still in a coma, Madam President. So when does it end? When do we finally stay focused on this? Because we actually have one last comment, Madam President, on not only is this germane, but remarkably important. You all may know one of our United States senators, the majority leader of the United States Senate, Chuck Schumer, was traveling the state, and he is calling on the U.S. Department of Justice to increase enforcement and penalties and used the RICO Act, as we all know, the Racketeer-Influenced and Corrupt Organizations Act, to investigate and prosecute organized retail theft rings in New York. And as we all know, Madam President, the RICO Act was used to prosecute organized crime, which is exactly what this is. So this is simply aggravating a petty larceny to a Class E felony in the event you're doing it in concert with others, which, as I said, is already a theory in our law. It's already something that is a very simple, common sense aspect of the law. And we actually now have United States Senator and Majority Leader Chuck Schumer agreeing with me. So for those reasons, Madam President, I respectfully request that you overrule the decision that this is non-germane and add this amendment to the bill in chief. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. I want to remind the House that the vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Show of hands has been requested. So ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 20.
The ruling of the chair stands and the bill in chief is before the House. Senator Gennaris.
Madam President, we've agreed to restore this to the non-controversial calendar.
The bill is restored to the non-controversial calendar. Read the last section.
Section 11. This action take effect on the 30th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Dabo, Gennaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Read the last, announce the results.
In relation to calendar 620, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Kanzari Fitzpatrick, Gallivan, Griffo, Hellman, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Weber, and White. Ayes 41, nays 20.
The bill is passed. Senator Gennaris.
Madam President, returning to motions for a moment, I offer amendments to the following third reading calendar bills by Senator Parker, calendar 292, by Senator Rivera, calendar 451.
Amendments are received, and the bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar. Senator Gennaro.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until tomorrow, Wednesday, April 3rd at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Wednesday, April 3rd at 3 p.m.